Welcome to Jimmy Bowen and Friends. Each week's episode features Jimmy Bowen and special guests like Wade Hayes, Rhonda Vincent, and Jimmy Fortune. Today's guest is Terry McBride. Now, here's Jimmy Bowen.
Show. We have got a fun night for you guys tonight. We're going to have a reunion with a guy who's got a career that spans way long. He has got a fantastic solo career. He's a great writer, great singer, and he's put a band back together, and we're going to tell you, well, I'll tell you his name, and then the band will come to you. But we got Terry McBride with us tonight, and I am so looking forward to him. This is going to be a lot of fun. You guys hang out, and we'll be right back after these words from our sponsors.
There's more Jimmy Bowen and Friends coming up right after this short break. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, welcome back. Our next guest, our guest tonight, is a gentleman I have just admired his vocals, his talent through the years, and watching his career and listen to the great music that he has put out through the years. And it's very exciting that you're here. I've wanted you for the last couple of shows, and schedules didn't work, but make welcome Mr. Terry McBride.
Jimmy, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Thank you so
much.
Man,
this is exciting for me because, I love what you've done in the business. And speaking of the business, then how did you get in the business to even start off with?
Well, I got the bug at an early age. My father was a singer, songwriter, touring musician. And so I grew up with a lot of music in our home, a lot of interesting characters coming and going. And I loved it. I loved it all. I can remember at a very early age, my job was my dad would allow me to sort of polish and clean the guitars way before I was big enough to play. So I loved not only the look of that, and also my dad. I looked up to him so much, that I just wanted to be just like him, like a lot of kids do, And then that's how it started for me. He was a serious guy, so when I was 9, he gave me a guitar that he bought in Mexico, and the action on it was so high. I don't know if he was testing me or, but he was a strong guy. I was 9. I did a lot of crying in my pillow at night, but it was tough. But I managed to figure out the chords and a few chords, and then he had to show me a few more after that. He's like, "Oh, I've created a monster," but I loved it, every facet, every bit of it. And then he turned me into a bass player early on. He's like, "Son, you want to play with me? I need a bass player." So we went to a little pawn shop and found a little SG copy, a little Gibson knockoff. And I loved it. Only 4 strings, 2 less than the guitar. Now you're talking. We can do something with this, And I loved it. I took right to it, and that's what I did for the early part of my career. I was sort of the singing bass player,
Right.
Then writing songs, in a closet sort of a songwriter. Hadn't really, shared my tunes with anybody, and then started making trips to Nashville. And then one thing led to another, fortunately, And that's how I'm ending up here tonight with you, Jimmy.
Yeah. Now you're with me. Oh, Lord. I don't know if that's good or bad, but I'm glad you're here anyway. Well, this next song, Sacred Ground, I've listened to that for years, and I love that song.
Oh, I do
too. And I've been even tempted to try it myself, but
cool.
but it's a great song. Tell us about Sacred Ground.
Well, people think this is I was fortunate to write a lot of the songs and hits and along the way. This one I didn't. I didn't write this song, but when I heard it, I wished I had.
Yeah.
It's one of those kind of songs. I was still living in Texas, and my A&R person at the label said, "I'm going to send you a song. Sounds like something you would write," And I thought, I'll be the judge of that, But when I put it on in my car, I'll never forget, cassette back in those days, of course, and you kids can Google that later. Yeah, what is that guy talking about? But it was so, I connected and could relate to every single line in it. It was telling my story, and that's what you hope to find as a singer and someone who's going to try and convince the audience, it's connecting with me.
Yeah.
It has to connect with me before I can get it to connect with the audience. And it did right away. I was just so knocked out, and I put it on hold as fast as I could. And then we cut it for the second album. It was the title of the second album. We released it, and it just took off. It was so exciting. It was fun to watch it, and it was fun to see the audience respond to it before it even hit radio. They were already connecting, and that's when you've got something. It was strong and real, and the guys did a great job on it with me too. It was a perfect fit for us.
Yeah, it was phenomenal the way y'all did that song.
Oh, man.
Now, you're going to do that tonight,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'm going to do it.
You're going to do it right now, right?
Yeah, I thought I would. Yeah.
Well, I'd love to hear it.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Terry McBride.
All right. We got married in high school, had a baby when we turned 18. I bagged groceries in the daytime. At night, I learned to fix TVs. When you come by things the hard way, well, you learn how to hold on tight. Don't think you can waltz in here and take her without a fight. Oh, this ain't just some neon love come lately. It's a precious thing you don't know nothing about. We were joined in the eyes of the Lord, in the eyes of our hometown. Go on and leave her alone, treading on sacred ground. Guess I took for granted she would never look at someone else. Now I got some patching up to do. Oh, and I don't need your help. I know you're the leaving kind. I sure hope you will. Before she goes and burns those bridges, took so long. Thing you don't know nothing about. We were joined in the eyes of the Lord, in the eyes of our hometown. Go on and leave her alone, you're treading on sacred ground. Go on. Sacred ground tonight, y'all.
All right. Don't go away. Jimmy Bowen and Friends will be right back. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
You're the only one who can do that song. That is amazing.
Oh, thank you. I've loved
that song ever since I heard it. And only Terry McBride can deliver that song.
Thank you, Jimmy. Oh, it's great, man. I appreciate that song. I still enjoy singing it all these years later. It's been a good song for us.
I wish you'd wrote it, but
yeah. Oh, dang it. That's how I met Kix Brooks at the number one party, which is not a bad way to meet a guy.
No, that's right.
In a pretty dang good mood that day. So
I'm one of those fans of yours and fans of the band that I'm really excited that you're doing this. So how does it feel getting McBride and the Ride back together and doing things? I think it's great myself. I love what y'all did. I love those recordings.
Well,
what does it mean to reunite?
Well, we're having a ball. I mean, we're really enjoying it. We're enjoying from the rehearsals to whatever, getting back together. Remembering those old days and, you know, reminiscing and reminding each other of things we've done. We found some old work tapes and things from even the road that we'd forgotten a few things that we had done. And so that's been exciting, kind of going back and in time. And really what we're doing, we're just embracing the 90s. That's what we were all about. Yeah. And so if you saw us in 92, and if you come see us next month, you're going to see pretty much the same set. And you're going to see the same guys singing and playing.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. I'm loving it. I'm hoping to catch one of your shows.
Oh,
I'm looking forward
to
that.
Definitely. Let me know. Love to have you out.
Oh, that'd be great. Well, now play something country. you're going to do for us tonight, right? You going
to
do that?
Yeah, I thought I'd do a little slow, sad song to wrap up the evening.
I can tell it's going to be slow and sad. Well, you do what you do best, my friend.
All right, man. I'll try for sure.
You will do it.
All right.
Terry McBride, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Something country. Oh. Well, the band took the break. The DJ played P. Diddy. She said, I didn't come here to hear something thumping from the city. Said, I shaved my legs, I paid my money. Play something country. Play something country. Crank up the band and play the steel guitar. Rock this bar. Two back and shotgun. I'm a George Strait junkie. Play something country. Play something country. Well, the bartender, yeah, y'all, it's closing time. She got this wife on her face and said, you're stuck on mine. I know. Place down the road, it's kind of funky. Way out in the country. Y'all play something country. Crank up the band, play the steel guitar. Pick it up a little, let's rock this bar. Be back and shot here, I'm a George Strait junkie. Play something country. Something country. Play something country. Ooh, yeah. Come on.
We'll be back with more Jimmy Bowen and Friends in just a moment. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, thank you. What did y'all think about Terry? Terry McBride. Woo, Lord. He is one talented gentleman. I'll tell you what, I am looking forward to seeing more of him and McBride and the Ride. What a great artist. We're going to close the show with you guys tonight, and we're going to kind of slow it down a little bit and do a little slow thing. And we hope that you've enjoyed the show. And this is an original tune, and it's new for us, but we're going to look forward to doing it for you. It's called Nothing Ain't Got Nothing to Do With You.
Never seem to win that tug of war. The only thing that really keeps me going is knowing when I finally walk through that front door, I'll have telephone, forget the bills.